This conference will now be recorded.
Today's concept name is SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle.
Okay.
SDLC, very, very important concept. SDLC, Software Development Lifecycle.
Okay.
Software development life cycle contains six phases. First one is initial phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, delivery and maintenance phase. Delivery and maintenance phase. Software development lifecycle contains six phases: initial phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, delivery and maintenance phase. Actually, we will work under only testing phase. Only if you know only testing knowledge, more than enough. But after course completion, if you want to keep the experience and after going to software company, who are the roles in the organization, what they are doing, roles and responsibilities, you should know. That is the reason we will learn all the phases of software development life cycle. Actually, only if you know testing knowledge is more than enough. But only for general knowledge purpose, we will learn all the phases roughly, not in clearly, roughly we will discuss. Roughly we will discuss. Even testing phase also here we will discuss very, very roughly. In future we will discuss about testing phase very clear manner. So first today, first concept, initial phase. Okay. Before going to initial phase, first of all we should know ICICI Bank people want one software.
Yeah.
ICICI Bank people want one software. They inquired which is the best software company for developing the software. So they got information. First, Infosys is the best. First, they will go to Infosys and they will tell the requirements. So they will tell the requirements, rough requirements they are telling, rough requirements. Roughly they are telling requirements. After telling the rough requirements, they will give estimation. Rough estimation. This is not at all final. This is rough estimation. They are giving rough estimation. After rough estimation, they will write official agreement. They will write official agreement. After official agreement, they will say to customer, sir, concerned person will come to your place and he will take the all the requirements. He will say to customer and he will take the all the customer details very clearly. Customer details very clearly. Concerned person will come to your place, sir. He will take the all the requirements very clearly. You gave rough requirement. This is not sufficient to complete this particular project. So concerned person will come to your place. Just to tell me your details and contact address, everything they will take from customer. Okay. Today, first phase, initial phase. Today, first phase, initial phase. Initial phase or requirement gathering phase. We can say another name, requirement gathering phase or requirement gathering phase. Initial phase or requirement gathering phase. Roles. Roles means employees. In this phase, we have two roles. One is business analyst. Second one is engagement manager. Main task, gathering the requirements from customer. Gathering the requirements from customer. Yes. First, we will discuss about business analyst task. First business analyst, he will take the appointment from customer. Sir, this is Akhil Reddy. I am from Infosys. I want to come to your place, sir. I want to gather the requirements very clearly. So just tell me your preferable time. That preferable time, I can come and I can collect the all the requirements very clearly. So first of all, he will take the appointment from customer. Before going to customer place, he will collect the template from company. Each and every software company requirement gathering purpose, they will maintain template. Template is nothing but it contains some predefined fields, just like this is the template. Name. Requirement one. Requirement two, requirement three, just like already it contains some predefined fields. So this is called a template. It contains some predefined fields. Just we need to fill the information. So the only requirement gathering purpose, each and every software company, they will maintain separately one template, that is called a requirement gathering template. Business analyst, before going to customer place, he will collect the template from company. Using this template, he will gather the all the requirements very clearly. So business analyst, first task, first of all, he will take the appointment from customer. Before going to customer place, he will collect the template from company, and he will go to customer place. Using this template, he will gather the all the requirements very clearly. So I completed within 1 minute, but business analyst, he will take nearly 2 to 3 months time. Why? Because so application means internally it having nearly thousands of pages or hundreds of pages. So each and every page requirements also he need to gather. So that's the reason he will take more time. Only single day he can't take all the requirements from customer. And moreover, in the market, customer what he want, he don't know. So first of all, he need to interact with the customer clearly. So different mentality people will be there in the market. So they don't know what he want, he don't know. So first of all, what is his expectations? First of all, we should know. Then only we can do work for him. So that's the reason business analyst, he will fully interact with the customer and he will gather the requirements and he will come back to the company. He will submit into the company. That is a business analyst task. Here main task is gathering the requirements from customer. So first of all, business analyst, he will take the appointment from customer. That appointment date, he will go to customer place. Before going to customer place, he will collect the template from company. Using this template, he will gather all the requirements very clearly and he will come back to the company. He will submit into the company. That is the business analyst task. He is the responsible for gathering the requirements. Only e business analyst main task is gathering the requirement. Okay, next, engagement manager. Whenever the requirement document has come to the company, engagement manager will check that requirement document. Whenever the requirement document has come to the company, engagement manager will check that requirement document. So whenever approaching to software company, he gave rough requirements. If at all same requirements or if at all any extra requirements, he will add the extra cost. So same requirements is there or he added any extra requirement, he will check. So if it is any extra requirements, he will add the extra cost also. If at all any confused requirements means I will tell you. So customer, he said he want one application, he want two buttons in the application. But he didn't mention where he want to, top of the page or center of the page or bottom of the page, corner of the page. He didn't mention anything. So in that situation, he will conduct a prototype demonstration with the customer. Prototype demonstration means I will write it. Prototype demonstration. prototype domain instrumentation is nothing but it is a roughly and rapidly developed model. It is a roughly and rapidly developed model. If you want gather the requirements, if you want give the requirement, always we will use prototype domain instrumentation. Why he is conducting prototype domain instrumentation? He want to take the written proof from customer. He want to take the written proof from customer. Sir, you want top of the page or center of the page or bottom of the page or corner of the page? Where you want exactly? Tell me. So he will take the written proof from the customer. So that is called engagement manager task. So what is engagement manager task? Whenever the requirement document has come to the company, engagement manager will check the requirement document. If at all any extra requirement, he will add the extra cost. If at all any confusion requirements, he will conduct a prototype domain instrumentation with the customer and he will gather the all the requirements very clearly. That is engagement manager task. In this phase, output document name is customer final documents. This is the normal word. In our real life, we will call customer requirements. This is the normal word, customer requirements. But different companies, they will call with different names. Some company, they are calling FRS. FRS means functional requirement specification. Some company, they are calling CRS. Same customer requirements, but different companies, they will call with different names. So some company they are calling FRS. FRS means functional requirement specification. Some company they are calling CRS, customer requirement specification. Some company they are calling BRS, business requirement specification. Some company they are calling URS, user requirement specification. Some company they are calling BDD, business design document. Some company they are calling BD, business document. Different companies, they will call with different names, but 90% of people they are calling FRS only. FRS means customer requirements. 90% of people, wherever you go worldwide, 90% of people they are calling FRS. FRS means customer requirements. So initial phase main output document is FRS. Initial phase output document is FRS. Here is main task, gathering the requirements, roles, business analyst and engagement manager. What is the business analyst task? First of all, he will take the appointment from customer. Before going to customer place, he will collect the template from company, and using this template, he will gather the all the requirements very clearly, and he will come back to the company, he will submit into the company. That is the business analyst task. Second one, engagement manager. Whenever the requirement document has come to the company, engagement manager will check the requirement document. If at all any extra requirement, he will add the extra cost. If at all any confusion requirements, he will conduct a prototype demonstration with the customer and he will gather the all the requirements very clearly. So in this phase, output document is customer requirements, but different companies, they will call with different names. Some companies calling FRS, CRS, BRS, URS, BDD, BD. So maximum we can say in this phase, output document is FRS. This FRS document is input for next phase. What is the next phase? What is the next phase?
Analysis phase.
Yes, analysis phase. Input document is FRS. Next phase, analysis phase. Main tasks. One is feasibility study. Tentative planning. Technology selection. Requirement analysis. Requirement analysis. Roles. Roles means employees. System analyst two. Project manager. Team manager. Project manager, team manager. Okay, right. First, so here analysis phase. They will analyze the all the customer requirement. Already they got customer requirement FRS. So they are analyzing the customer requirement. They are not doing any task, sir. Just they are analyzing the customer requirements. So already customer requirement document came to analysis phase. They are analyzing the customer requirements. So here three people, system analyst to project manager, three manager, team manager, they are sitting and they are analyzing the requirements. They are not doing any task, just yeah. They are analyzing the customer requirements. Okay, right. First one is feasibility study. Feasibility means possibility. Feasibility means possibility. So customer gave some requirements. Based on the requirements, this project is possible or not, they will analyze. Feasibility means possibility. Is there any possibility? Can we complete this particular project very successfully or not? They will analyze. So that's why that is called feasibility study. Feasibility. Feasibility means possibility. Is there any possibility? Can we complete this particular project successfully or not? They will analyze. So that's why we can say it is a feasibility study. Possibility. Is there any possibility? There is possibility or not? They will analyze. So that is called feasibility study. Next, tentative planning. Tentative means temporary. Tentative means temporarily they will plan. So they said they want, customer said he want that application within 3 months. So we need to complete this particular project within 3 months. How we can complete? Okay, how much time we need? Okay, how much time we need? How much resources we need? How much technology we need? How much software we need? They will analyze. So that is called tentative planning. Tentative means temporarily. Right, over. Next. Technology selection. Technology selection is very, very important, sir. So customer is said the developed project should work in Windows 7 environment. Customer is said the developed project should work in Windows 7 environment. Which technology suits for Windows 7? We need to choose the technology. Either Java or .NET or PHP. Which technology suits for Windows 7? So compulsory they need to choose the particular technology. Which technology suits for Windows 7? They will choose the technology. It's very, very important. For example, you are the customer, sir. You said, sir, I need 3 buttons in the application. So you said, sir, I need 1 application. In that 3 buttons I need, you said, but I developed only 2 buttons. So then you will raise the complaint, sir. Actually, I said 3 buttons, sir, but you developed only 2 buttons. This is not at all correct. Okay, you will argue with me and I will give explanation. Sorry, sir, I miscommunication problem. Sorry. I give some explanation. Sometimes you will compromise, sometimes you will not compromise. Okay, that is not big issue. Okay, already I gave explanation. So manually, I am also doing manually. So some mistakes will be there. So manually we are doing, human errors will be there. Okay, you need to try to, you need to understand, but you are not compromise. Okay, you are arguing with me, you are fighting with me. Okay, leave it. Okay. And if it is not satisfying the Windows 7 environment, that time you will not accept. You will not accept that particular project. So I will tell you one example. In Imayat Nagar, in Hyderabad, Imayat Nagar, we have one company, Health Access Company, healthcare domain project. So nearly 66 members, they did 2.5 years. 66 members, they did one project. 2.5 years, they didn't. They did that particular project. So after actually customer said the developed project should work in Windows Service Pack 3. Windows XP Service Pack 3. The developed project should work in Windows XP Service Pack 3. That is the customer requirement. During delivery, it is not supporting Windows XP Service Pack 3. It is supporting XP Service Pack 2. Customer simply rejected. Customer simply rejected. If it is one button is missing, sir, please give me back application. I will add one more button. I will give you back. Okay, I can give. I can add the button. That is not big issue. But if it is not satisfying the customer specified environment, that time customer will not accept that application. Nearly 66 members, 2.5 years, they did that particular project. End of the project, that is not satisfying the customer specified environment. So customer simply rejected application. 66 members on this part, they lost job. So technology selection is very, very important. If it is one button is missing, that is not big issue. So we can add one more button and we can give you application to customer. That is not big issue. But if it is not satisfying the customer specified environment, customer will not act, will not compromise. For example, I am the person, I am the customer. In my office, I have 100 systems. In 100 systems, I am using Windows 7 environment, Windows 7 operating system I am using in my lab. I want one software, X software I want. That software should work in Windows 7 environment. I said, okay, I gave money also. But during delivery, it is not satisfying Windows 7 environment. So I will not accept. Why should I compromise? I'm paying some crores of rupees. Why should I compromise? Why? Because so only for this X software purpose, I need to maintain another CPU beside my CPU. So once again, I need to buy 100 CPUs and I need to maintain another operating system. Why should I compromise?
Yeah.
So I will not compromise. If it is one button is missing, I will raise the complaint. Sir, this is not at all good. I said three buttons, but you developed only two buttons. So this is not at all good. So they will give some explanation and they will add one more button. They will give back. That is not big issue. But if it is not satisfying the customer specified environment, customer will not compromise. Even me also, I will not compromise. Why should I compromise? Okay, only for this software purpose, I need to maintain another CPU beside my CPU. Why should I? So technology selection is very, very important. Here three members, system analyst, project manager, team manager, they are totally concentrated only on technology selection. Which technology suits for Windows 7 environment? Customer specified the developed project should work in Windows 7 environment. Which technology suits for Windows 7? They will choose the particular technology, Java, .NET, or PHP. Which technology suits for Windows 7? They will choose the particular technology and they will develop the application. Okay, right. Next, requirement analysis. Customer gave you some requirements. So if we want to complete this particular project, we need money. We need money. We need software. We need hardware. We need time also. We need premises, employees. So we need all those things. We need all those things under technology. Oh, technology, very, very important. Technology. Which technology? .NET, Java, or PHP? Which technology? Okay, technology. We need all those things. We have or not, they will analyze. Temporarily, they are analyzing. So we need all those things. We have or not. How much money we have right now? How much software we have? How much hardware we have? How much time we have? Premises and employees, technology. So we need all those things. How much we need to recruit or how much we need to take from other resources. So they will analyze. So that's why that is called a requirement analysis. These three members, they will sit and they will analyze all the customer requirements. So after analyzing the requirements, they will add some points to FRS. They will add some points to FRS. So in this phase, output document is SRS, system requirement specification. System requirement specification. In this phase, output document is SRS, system requirement specification. System requirement specification. This system requirement specification is input for next phase. What is the next phase, sir?
Design.
Design phase. Input document is SRS. Next phase, design phase. tasks. High level designing. Low level designing. High level designing, low level designing. Roles. One is chief architect. Second one is technical lead. One is chief architect, second one is technical lead. So already they got FRS, sorry, SRS. They are analyzing and they are designing. Now they are designing. Okay. So first, wherever you go, after getting the project, each and every software company, they will divide the whole project into some modules. They will divide the whole project into modules. Wherever you go, if it is any software company, any type of domain, after getting the project, they will divide the whole project into some modules. They will divide the whole project into some modules. That is called high level designing. They will divide the whole project into some modules. So that is called high level designing. High level designing done by chief architect. High level designing done by chief architect. While doing high level designing, he will follow one code. That code name is UML language. UML. UML. UML means Unified Modeling Language. You will follow one language. That language name is Unified Modeling Language, UML language. So you will divide the whole project into some modules. So that is called high level designing. High level designing done by chief architect. While doing high level designing, you will follow one code. That code name is UML language. Using this UML language, you will divide the whole project into some modules. Okay, right. Next, each and every module divided into some submodules. Each and every module divided into some submodules. That is called low level designing. That is called low level designing. Each and every module divided into some submodules. So that is called low level designing. Low level designing done by technical lead. Low level designing done by technical lead. Low level designing done by technical lead. While doing low level designing, he will follow one code. That code name is pseudo code. P silent here. Pseudo code. Pseudo code. Pseudo. Pseudocode is nothing but it is a set of English instructions. Using this set of English instructions, he will divide the one module into some submodules. One module into some submodules. That is called low level designing. Low level designing done by technical lead. So in this phase, after designing, they will add some points. They will add some points. In this phase, output document is TDD, technical design document. TDD, technical design document. TDD, technical design document. TDD, technical design document. This technical design document is input for next phase. What is the next phase?
Coding.
Coding phase. Input document TDD. This is developer development phase. Here is no work. TDD coding phase. Roles. Programmers. Task. Programmer. So developers. So after getting the TDD, based on the customer requirements, developers, they will develop the application. There is no restriction for developers. There is no restriction for developers. While developing the application, they will follow coding standards. Coding standards. So if they follow coding standards, application performance is very good. And if they are not following coding standards, application performance is very poor. So while developing the application, they will follow coding standards and they will develop the application. That is the programmer's task. But only one restriction for developers: while developing the application, if at all any color required, like heading, comment, image insertion. So in this situation, so company specified colors only they should use. Only one restriction for developers. Based on the customer requirements only, they will develop the application. While developing the application, they will follow coding standards, and only restriction for developers while developing the application, if at all any color required, company specified colors only they should use. Actually, customer only he will tell the all the requirements. If at all customer he is not specified particular colors, in that situation, company specified colors only they should use. That is only developers, only one restriction for developers. Remaining based on the customer requirements only they will develop the application. That is the programmer's task. Okay, only they will develop the application only. So in this phase, output document is a CD. They will add some points. Points means they will write the code. So in this phase, output document is SCD, source code document. In this phase, output document is SCD, source code document, right? This SCD, they will send it to testing department. Next phase, testing phase. Main task, testing. Roles, testers. So what is our task? We will discuss roughly, and in future we will discuss very clear manner. So just roughly we will discuss today. First, requirement document or FRS. They will send one set of copy developers, another set of copy testers. This is developers. They will send one set of copy developers, another set of copy testers. After getting the requirements, developers, they will divide the whole project into some modules. So that is called high level designing. Each and every module divided into some submodules. That is called low level designing. Each and every submodule, they will divide build wise, they will develop build wise, and they will sending to testing department. So this is the first build they are sending to testing department. This is the B1. B1 means build one. Part of the submodule. Called build. Build wise they will develop and they will sending to testing department. They developed first build and they are sending to testing department. Parallelly, testers will read the customer requirements. So that is called review. Study the customer requirements. Each and every software company, they will give nearly 2 to 3 months time to review the customer requirement. What is customer expectations? First of all, we should know. So that's the reason each and every software company, they will give nearly 2 months, 3 months, 15 days, 20 days based on the project size. They will give some time. So within the time, we need to understand all the customer requirements. That is called review. We will study the customer requirements. That is called review. While doing review, if you have any doubt, we will list out in review report. This review report, we will send it to author of the customer requirement document. Okay, we have some doubts in the customer requirements. We will send it to author of the customer requirement document. Who is the author of the customer requirement document? Who is the responsible for customer requirement document?
Engagement. Engagement manager and the development. Engagement manager and the business analyst.
Only business analyst is the responsible for the customer requirement document, sir. So okay. We will send it to this review report to business analyst.
Okay.
This review report we will send it to business analyst. He will give all explanation and he will clarify the all the doubts. After clarifying the doubts, we will take test case template. What is the test case template? I will tell you later. We will take test case template, test TC template.
Okay.
Test case template. We will take test case template and we will write the all the test cases. We will take test case template and we will write the all the test cases. Whenever the first build released from development department, we will execute all the test cases on this build. We will execute all the test cases on this build. Based on the customer requirement, this build is properly developed or not, we will do testing. If it is developed, stop testing. If it is developed, stop testing.
Yeah.
If it is not developed, then we will raise the defect to developers using defect profile template, DPT. If you want to raise the defect, so if you send the mail and message, they will not accept. So the separate format we should follow. Each and every software company defect raising purpose, they will provide defect profile template. Using this defect profile template, we will raise the defect to developers. Then developers will think, is this really defect or not? If they feel yes, then they will rectify and they will send it to testing department as build 2. B2. Build 2. Once again, we will do testing. Based on the customer requirement, this build is really rectified or verified. Once again, we will do testing. If it is rectified, stop testing. If it is not rectified, once again, we will raise the defect to developers. Then developers will think, is this really defect or not? If they feel yes, defect, then they will rectify and they will send it to testing department as build 3. B3. Once again, we will do testing. Based on the customer requirement, this build is really rectified or verified. If it is rectified, stop testing. If it is not rectified, we will raise the defect to developers. This process continuously we will do up to until product is defect free. Until product is defect free. This process continuously we will do. So using defect profile, using defect profile template, we will raise the defect to developers, rectify, and they will send it to testing department once again. Once again, we will do testing. Is this really rectified or verified? If it is rectified, stop testing. If it is not rectified, once again, we will raise the defect to developers. This process continuously we will perform until the product is defect free, our project is defect free, our application is defect free. So here a testing engineer should know only two things. Here observe carefully. First of all, we need to understand the requirements. Okay. And after understanding the requirements, how to write the test cases. If you know these two things, you can work with any software company, any type of project, anywhere in the world. So testing engineer should know only two things. First of all, we need to understand the customer requirements very clearly. After understanding the requirements, how to write the test cases. If you know these two things, more than enough.
Okay.
In this case, output document is quality product or quality application. Quality application. All right. So in this case, output document is quality application. Okay. Testing, coding and testing is over. Next, we need to deliver the application into client environment. Last, delivery and maintenance phase. Delivery and maintenance phase. So main task is delivery. Delivery or deploy or install. Any name you can use. Delivery the application into, deploy the, install the application into client environment. Into client environment. Client means customer. Client environment. Deliver the application into client environment, deploy the application into client environment, install the application into client environment. Roles. Roles means employees. One is deployment engineer. Or senior software test engineers. Senior software test engineer. C senior software test engineer. So after testing, we need to go to customer place and we need to install the application into client environment. All the companies will not maintain deployment engineers. Why? Because deployment will not happen regularly, daily or monthly. So 6 months once or yearly once, we will deliver the application into client environment. Only one day purpose, all the companies will not maintain deployment engineers. So senior software test engineer only will go to customer place and he will install the application into client environment. For that purpose, each and every software company, they will provide installation document. They will provide installation document. How to install the application into client environment? They will provide some list of guidelines. Using that list of guidelines, we will install the application into client environment. We will not apply own ideas. Whatever they given, that guideline strictly we will follow and we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, then we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines correct. Otherwise, we can come to a conclusion that the given guidelines not correct. Why? Because we will not apply our own ideas. Whatever they given, that guidelines we will strictly we will follow. We will install the application into client environment. That is called delivery or deploy or install. So all the companies will not maintain deployment engineers. So there is no deployment engineers in the software companies. Senior software test engineer only will go to customer place and he will install the application into client environment. For that purpose, each and every software company, they will provide installation document. Using that installation document guidelines, we will install the application into client environment. If at all installation successful, given guidelines correct. Otherwise, installation failure, so given guidelines not correct. So that is installation over. Next, maintenance. While working with this application, customer, if you face any problem, so that is called task. While working this application, this is the application, he is working with this application. So while working this application, if you face any problem, then that is called task. So based on the task, he will raise the complaint to software company. So based on the task, based on the complaint, they will arrange one person to solve the problem. So one person will come and he will solve the problem. And once again, next day, once again, he got problem. Once again, he will raise the complaint to software company. Concerned person will assign and he will come to customer place and he will rectify the problem. So if you face regularly, continuously, if you face any problems, you will request to software company, sir, while working with this application, regularly I'm facing some problems, sir. Please provide a group of people in my place. I will pay the money, but please provide a group of people in my place. So upon customer request, a group of people will come to customer place and they will work here only. So that is called client location. That is maintenance. That is maintenance. Upon customer request, a group of people will come to customer place and they will do work here only, customer place only. Customer only pay the money, but they are working with so-and-so Infosys company. So, but they are working in work location is client location, client place. That is maintenance. These are the six phases. SDLC content, six phases: initial phase, analysis phase, design phase, coding phase, testing phase, delivery and maintenance phase. Over.
Yeah,
this recorded file I will send you. Notes already I have sent you, sir.
Okay, sir.